Hello, welcome back to my channel. My name is Fallon, and today I'm going to be doing a vinyl collection update. I know that this is basically a vinyl channel now, but here we are. I have a pretty big stack of records to show you right here. These are ones that I've collected in February and in March. March isn't over yet, but I'm not going to buy any in the rest of the month or any that will be here in the rest of the month. I have a few pre-orders. This is what I have. I have 12 records to show you. 10 of these I got on one shopping trip that me and my boyfriend went on. It was our 1 year anniversary, so we went on a huge trip. We got more stuff than just vinyl. Like, he got me some shirts and we got each other like Funko Pops and stuff like that, but I'm just gonna do vinyl because I don't feel like going around my house and collecting all of that. Also, I filmed this video with him a while ago, but I was just about to go edit it and I just looked terrible. So I am sorry, honey, but that couldn't be seen by public eyes. So I will start with the records that Nick got me. All of these, except for the ones that I will specify, are from Newbery Comics, if you're curious. First one is Joy Division's Level Tear Us Apart. This is a 12-inch single, which is very interesting. Has this really cute fold-out, and I absolutely love Joy Division, but I don't know if anyone else has this, but for some reason, I get weird anxiety over starting collecting a new band's records, because then I'm like, oh, now I'm gonna have to get all of their records every time I go on a trip until I have them all, which is absolutely not true, but I just have an ill brain. But I'm happy that he started off my Joy Division collection so I can start collecting their other records, because I want to, but then I just get weird and in my head about it. Anyways, this is the Halloween edition of this single, and so it is on this cool orange vinyl. I think I'm going to get their album Closer because it's on clear vinyl at all the Newberries I've seen. And next he got me Vane's Error Zone, which I love this album. I've been putting off getting it because the colored pressings were so expensive. And it's actually really funny because when we were checking out at this record store, he had already bought his. I was holding a copy of this. It was $20, but I was pretty sure it was going to be black, and he came over and he saw me holding it and I was like, should I get this? Like, should I risk it if it's black? And he was like, no, don't get it. Don't risk it. And then we got to the car and he had this for me. It's a stunning neon green with yellow splatter. I am just obsessed with this. I love it so much. Then he got me the It Follows soundtrack, which is one of our new favorite horror movies. I know it's a cult classic, but we hadn't seen it before, and I was just obsessed with this soundtrack. And this is also a great vinyl to play while I'm reading horror. If you want some horror books to read, you can check out my last video. But yeah, I have been loving reading horror books while listening to this. It's a stunning pressing. It is blue with firework splatter. And I love it so much. The last record that Nick got me is the Napoleon Dynamite soundtrack. This is obviously one of my favorite movies. Has been for a really long time. I love watching this with my mom because it's basically like people used to do those Rocky Horror Picture things and like act it out in front of the screen. That's what watching Napoleon Dynamite is like with me and my mom. And it's on this, I think it was called Heckin' Clear or something stupid like that. Next is all of the records that I got for myself. I will start with these two. These are the two that I got while we were in North Carolina. Nick and I went on a trip to North Carolina for his 19th birthday, and we went to two different record stores. Well, we went to a few, but we got stuff at two stores. So first, I got Interpol's A Fine Mess EP. This is the most recent thing that they have put out, and I really love it. It's fantastic. It's 5 songs long. And I also got their album Antics. I love it, it's fantastic. Probably my third favorite record by them. The other Interpol album I got from a Newbery is Marauder. This is their most recent full-length album that came out in 2018, and I feel like it was kind of a different direction for them. Production-wise, I sort of went somewhere new, but I really enjoy this album, and it is on Cream. This just looks white to me, but they said it was Cream. So I have two brand new records. I have their single Mene/Out of Range, and it has this like transparent piece of paper that like goes over it, which is cool. It is on clear as well. So I have their 3 demos reworked as well. Also, I'm really mad because the top of this is like split, but I'll have to glue that. But it's like die cut, so that comes out, which is cool. I really wanted to get their whole like leaked demos thing, but they only put it out on cassettes, so that's upsetting. Next, I got Poppy's I Disagree. This was a runner-up for my favorite albums of 2020. If you want to watch that video, you can go watch it, but I really enjoy this album. It's very, you know, baby metal influenced, or inspired by baby metal, and it is on this clear with red splatter. Also, I don't know if any of you guys watch the YouTuber Rachel Oates, but I feel like Poppy looks like Rachel Oates. I don't know why. Picked up Movement's No Good Left to Give. This was, I think, number 4 on my favorite albums list. It looks like this. I was holding off on getting this pressing for a while because I wasn't sure how it would look, but it is stunning. I love it. It looks like a marble countertop, and I'm just obsessed with it. This is such a good album, such a good direction for Movement's. The last record that I picked up is Beach Bunny's newest EP, Blame Game. I really love Beach Bunny. This was a great EP. It's only 4 songs long, but I really like it. And it is this hot pink vinyl, and it came in this little, like, plastic bag. I've never seen this before. I've seen, like, paper records that have, like, plastic on the inside, but I've never seen just, like, this plastic bag. It's kind of cool. It does, like, make the record stick to it, though. It's, like, kind of hard to get out. But I love the aesthetic of this. It's very, like, Stranger Things vibes. It also came with a pack of stickers, and I put the stickers on my reading journal. But yeah, that is all of the records that I've collected recently. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure to like, and yeah, I'll see you guys next time. Bye!